Sydney mum has been threatened with legal action with her neighbours complaining about her toddler's excessive shouting and screaming. Janin Mayer faces a $550 fine after complaints from other residents of the block of flats. So should apartment residents be fined for having noisy children? That's our daily dilemma today, and Rowan Smith joins us from news.com.au. Now, Rowan, this woman took to Facebook to voice her anger. That's always a good way to do it.
She did. She got a lot of feedback as well. So we know that we all live very close to one another, particularly in our capital cities in these shoebox apartments. So this kind of thing is going to happen. Unfortunately for her, clearly she's got her hands full with a 19-month-old who won't stop crying and won't stop screaming. I can see why Body Corporate did what they did. They sort of have to hold maybe everybody accountable to these standards that suit the majority. And in this case, it does involve noise.
But this is, but when they say, you know, oh, should residents be banned from having noisy children, there is no other type of children.
That's right.
Exactly right.
But this one says from very early in the morning until late at night.
That seems
there
to
is
be...
no other type of children.
Yes, that
that's
seems
what they
to be
do.
A long time to be noisy.
Oh, but at 19 months of age, I mean, why not? Why didn't these residents, these so-called concerned residents, actually knock on the mother's door and say, listen, it sounds like it's a bit noisy and rough in your household. Is everything all right? Can we... do you want to come round for a cup of tea or coffee or... Because 19-month-olds do your head in. It is like... It'd be easier to negotiate with a terrorist than a 19-month-old. And no, it would be. And I feel for this poor woman because she's pregnant as well, and it is tough sometimes with a little one. And they wake up, they scream, they whinge, they don't want to get dressed, they don't want to put their shoes on, they don't want to and then they don't want to go to sleep
very
at night.
Very late at night.
But I think
she's having another one as well.
She is. She's
with
pregnant.
Another one. So what, is she meant to keep the newborn quiet?
Yeah.
What's she meant to do? Wrap a pillow around
her? Surely there's difference between a serious case where you're trying to settle a child and then there's nightmare neighbours that have loud music playing or no consideration for others that cause serious disruption to residents with no consideration for anyone else. Surely that's a genuine noise complaint.
And maybe the mother with the child should have gone to see the neighbours and say, you know, what's your beef? Instead of going on Facebook. I mean, you need to talk the issues through with your neighbours.
Some people don't talk well and don't have consideration for others, so you can try and negotiate with
them.
Part of the problem with this, I think, is the way that the message was delivered.
Sure.
You know, there wasn't that conversation and the language...
It was an anonymous complaint, wasn't it?
Yeah, but also from Body Corporate, please refrain from allowing your child to make excessive noise... immediately into the future. I don't think, you know...
They were all kids once. It makes me so cross. Mm. All of these people were kids once and made a whole lot of noise and were disruptive. Let's have some kindness and compassion, especially for new mums. Goodness me.
And consideration for others. Rowan, thank you very much for joining us. I appreciate it.